Goodbye, my love. I'll be seeing you when the lights go. When I put my
hey, this is Diane Birch. You're watching my Yamaha photo shoot, and we're currently in an amazing abandoned hotel from the 20s. So it just makes it even cooler.
My crimson
dust. I always wanted to be taken very seriously as a pianist, so I used to not tell people that I sang. I mean, I didn't really consider myself a singer just because my voice wasn't really anything special. It was just kind of mine. And it was really only when people started encouraging me and I started realizing that there was all these people making music that actually didn't have the greatest voice either. I'm like, well, maybe I can do it. This first album was so personal to me that I felt like it was just really important that it was all mine. I felt like it was really my story. I'd written songs with other people, but it never really captured what I was trying to say. I felt really passionate about, you know, writing the album in its entirety. There was a few songs that we wanted to cut for the album that we just felt like kind of had a New Orleans flavor, and we wanted to add even more of a New Orleans flavor to it. And so we just thought, why not? Let's just go to New Orleans. We went down there and it was great. I mean, it was just super magical. I mean, at one point we wanted to put some tambourine on something, and so we like called this guy called the Tambourine Man, and like 20 minutes later he like shows up and he's like playing tambourine. Like, I didn't realize it was such an art to playing tambourine until I saw this guy. But yeah, it was just super fun. I wish I could have stayed longer.
It ain't gonna be the same without you.
The current tour I'm on is my first headlining tour, which is really fun. I've got a great band. We just kind of drive around endlessly for hours at a time and play shows, and it's really great. I've always been sort of an opener for other artists, so it's nice to finally do a headlining show where people are singing my songs and they don't look like, you know, deer in headlights. So it's a lot more fun.
Good enough.
I'm getting ready to play Bonnaroo, which is going to be really exciting. Just wrapping up the last few of these dates, and then that's going to be the bookend of this tour. And then I go to Europe for about a month. I'm playing a few things with Stevie Wonder, which I'm really excited about because I love Stevie Wonder. And then I go to Korea, and then I'm going to play Fuji Rocks Festival in Japan, which I'm super excited about. Now, I was over there in December, and it was a few months after the record came out, and I was pretty surprised at how many people were at the shows, and they seemed really into it. And yeah, I loved Japan. I mean, I had the most amazing time, so I'm... If I have a career in Japan, I'm thrilled because I love it there. I just think Yamaha's a great piano. They're just so all around great in so many areas. I love the sound, I love the tone. I think they're great value. I've always played Yamahas. I actually had one in London, and I spent most of the year that I was living there writing my album, and just the sound of the piano itself was really great, and it really seemed to inspire a lot of the songs that were on the album. Hey everyone, that's it. Thanks so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed it.